What's up, animators? So today I'm going to show you how to make a shape tween. It's a very basic shape tween. So we'll have a star here and we'll transform it into the circle. Not so bad. All right, let's get started. So let me pause this one here and just explain here a bit. So here I am at frame one. It's also keyframe. Have star. That's the key event, key moment is that my shape here is a star. Then over at the next keyframe, frame 30, it's a circle. And in between here, that's the shape tween. So all I did was make a star and then a circle, and Adobe Animate here did the rest, did the transformation there for me, the shape shift and the color shift. So change this color as well, either a green star and then red star. All right, so start making one here, file new. And these presets, I don't really care what presets you go with, as long as it's frame rate 30 frames per second. So it's a 1 second animation and action script 3.0. So create right here. Get a nice fresh canvas. Here we go. All right, so I started out with the star. So a star, how do I make a star? None of these shapes here look like a star. If I go to the shape tool, let me call down the left mouse button here on the rectangle tool. There we go. I got a rectangle primitive tool, oval primitive tool, poly star tool. To make a star, you're gonna go with this one here, poly star tool. So you're gonna make polygons and stars. So I'm gonna click on that one. There we got poly star tool there selected. Then I go here to the properties panel. These are the properties for my tool, for my poly star tool. Down here at the bottom, the style of my shape right now is polygon. If I click on it, I can convert it over to a star. So now I can make a star. How many points do you want on your star? 5. That's fine with me. 5 is okay. You guys can change it, play it around, make it 3 points, 10 points, as many points as you want on your star. Star point size, that's kind of, I guess, for lack of a better term, the pointiness of your star, of the legs on your star, points on your star, how pointy they are. All right, and here's for the color of my star, fill color, the color of the inside of the star, green, blue. I'm gonna go with this light blue color, or let me maybe go with darker blue right here. Stroke, that's the border on the outside. I'm gonna go with no stroke, because a stroke usually, when you tween it, it tweens separate than the other object sometimes, especially if you have another object one with a stroke, one without a stroke, you'll see the stroke kind of coming off of there. Like it was just breaking off of your object. So I'm gonna go with no stroke, looks a little neater, get a cleaner looking animation. All right, I'm gonna make a star here in the upper left-hand corner. I'm gonna hold down the shift key and then hold down the left mouse button so I can get a nice good looking star. See, now I can, gives me better control of when I try to make my star. So something like that. And then let go of the mouse, let go of shift. And there's my star. And it doesn't have to be standing up straight like that. It could be at an angle. What'll be fair and honest, like what is the top of the star anyways, right? So I like to think of it as a person standing up, the Carl Jr. star. I'm always thinking about food. All right, so here I am at keyframe one. I have a star in the upper left-hand corner, a blue star. That's what I have going on here at frame one, keyframe, first keyframe that I have here. All right, I'm gonna make a 1 second animation. Over here at frame 30, it's gonna turn into a circle. I'll make a red circle. So I wanna create a frames to frame 30. So I'm gonna right click on 30 right here. And I'm gonna select insert keyframe. That's gonna copy that blue star all the way to frame 30. But frame 30 is gonna be different. It's gonna be a keyframe. It'll actually have the a little circle that's in there filled in. Let me try to zoom into that. There we go. So you can see here's my two keyframes. I have a keyframe at 1 with the filled in circle, and have another keyframe at 30 with the filled in circle. And then there's this little bar right here dividing it, letting me know it's separate than the rest of this. So from frame 1 to 29, I have the same thing in there, which is a star. If I make any changes in there, it's gonna change the blue star there. Whereas at 30, I can change 30 without affecting the other frames before that, separated by this bar there. Go ahead and get out of there. All right, so now here at frame 30, I'm actually gonna delete this star right here. I'm gonna go to here, selection tool. I'm gonna click on the star, and then hit the delete key on my keyboard and it's gone. There it is. So like I mentioned earlier, that frame there, it's separate from all the other frames from frame 1 to 29. Frame 1 to 29, I still have the star in there. And I'm able to look at these other frames by holding down the left mouse button on this blue bar right here. It's called your timeline cursor there, or your playhead right there. Let me go over to 30. There we am at 30. I can click in there too, make sure I'm at 30. And while frame 30, separate keyframe, separate event, I can make my red circle here. So back over here to the shape tool, hold down the left mouse button, select oval tool, and I'm just going to change the color here for the fill, go over to red, there we go. Notice I don't have those other tool options earlier to make a star or the points on the star, because now I don't have the poly star tool, it's just a circle there. These are features there for my circle. All right, so to make a perfect circle, I'm gonna hold on the shift key, hold down the left mouse button and drag. I'm doing this while I'm frame 30. I can make a big giant circle, small circle, because it also changed size. So that looks like a good circle there. Let go of the mouse, then shift, there we go. So from frame 1 to 29, I have the star, and at 30, I have the circle. So now to do the tweening, the in-betweening, to animate the frames in between them, I can just have Adobe do that for me. So just right-click anywhere between frame 1 and 29, right-click, and here I get these options here to tween. Make sure you go with create shape tween, shape tween. We're going to change the shape of it and the color and the location of our object here. So it's going to go from star to circle, from blue star upper left-hand corner to red circle lower right-hand corner. Boom. And there it is, mid-change already. All right, go to frame 1, play button, and there's the tweening right there. Bam. All right, I hit the play button again. There you go, bam. You want to loop this, you continuously see it. As you, as the animator, click on this loop icon right here, and you get a blue bar like this. For some reason, it's never wide enough to cover everything. So hover over the edge that needs to be pulled out. Hover your mouse over it until you get a double-sided arrow. Hold down the left mouse button and drag, and just drag right there. Hold down left, hold down the left mouse button, drag over, and now if I hit the play button, that's active there. It'll loop anything inside that blue bar right there. There it is. And then I preview the animation, control enter. You get a preview of your animation right here. There it is. And all previews are going to loop, even though they may not look like a looping animation. When you hit control enter, it's just going to repeat it again, whether you have this on or on. This is just for you to view it here repeatedly as the animator. But if I control enter, get the little preview window there and just close it out. So I'm done. I'm just going to save my project here. File, save as. When you're saving your project, make sure the file type is .fla. That's a flash file, Adobe Animate file. You can always open it back up right here in Adobe Animate. Let's say you want to change the background color. You want to add another animation in there. You'll have that saved in there. So let's see. Star to circle shape tween. Whatever works, right? And then save. That's saved. All right, so now I want my animation. I want an MP3 file. MP3 is audio. MP4 is a video file that I can upload into social media. So file, and then you're going to go down to export right here. And make sure you go to export video media, this one right here. So you can have the option to quickly make it into MP4. So for format, make sure it's H.264. It'll make an MP4 for you. These presets are fine right there. It'll match the presets here of whatever we chose earlier when you first started your document. If I want to make the background transparent, I can activate that. No need for that. Leave this active here. I have a check mark right there inside the Start Media Encoder Render Queue immediately. That way it starts converting into an animation, to a video file, as soon as you export. Well, not as soon as you export. You have to wait for the other application, the video, the media encoder to appear, and then it'll create your media file there, your video file. All right, so just wait a moment here. Here we go. So you get the Adobe Media Encoder. I waited what seemed to be about a full minute. The time did change on my clock on the right-hand corner, which you cannot see. I have it hidden from you guys. But it did take about a full minute for this to appear. So do not be alarmed if you render it out on your desktop and you can't find it. Wait for this to appear. Get that check mark there and you're good to go. So here's my video file. Open up in VLC Media Player. It's even taking its time to open that, huh? All right. Waiting. Here we go. There it is back there. And boom. Quick animation there. A little bit of a lag. So it didn't render very well. But there it is. If this was too easy for you, I do have another animation you guys can watch. Another video, how to make another animation. And that might be a lot more challenging and rewarding for everyone. If this was way too easy. But thank you for watching. Have an awesome day. If you like to support the channel, you can subscribe, like, share, leave a comment. Anything helps. Take care. Bye.